Alright, so who's gonna start first? I would really like to start first with the deck that actually needs to set up, and with the deck that actually requires a setup. Starting with Orbital Wii, and following that startup, I have two Weezings, Fion, Quick Ball, extra card to draw, which is Rangrel, and that's actually a pretty good card. Oh, my opponent started with the Crobat Wii. That's so bad to see. Alright, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna grab myself one copy of Coughing. Gonna go with that Quick Ball play, and we'll discard this energy at the end for the Crobat play. Gonna put Fion on the bench, and we'll do the Crobat play. Fortunately, no energy card. Wow, what a mess. Guess I can preserve Orbital by getting like Tapu Koko in play. And I can also use Private Wisdom, which I should play. Aura Energy, perfect. And then I can research for 7, so turn 1 was pretty damn good turn play. I can strafe and hit for 20, and I might switch my Orbital with the benched Pokemon, but obviously for now I'm just gonna keep it in the active spot. And my opponent played Quick Ball for Boss's Orders. I'm still trying to see which deck is he. So obviously he is playing a Dragapult deck, a baby one, but not sure if there's also a Dragapult Remax in that deck as well. So there's a research for 7. So at least he have research and oh, two Boss's Orders discarded. Yeah, that's rough. And another GP. So detonation gas, as long as this Pokemon is in your active Pokemon, put one damage counter on each of your opponent's basic Pokemon between turns. So only on basic Pokemons, unfortunately. We do have Twin Energy, we can pay that retreat cost, and we can use this Marnie as well. Is there anything I actually need? Okay, so definitely we'll use that Vorpal ability so I can claim the space at my bench. Additionally, we'll also play that Primate Wisdom. And right now I can use Splattering Sludge, so I can't still take a knockout against my opponent and Dreepy, but next turn hopefully one of them gonna be knocked out. So that's a big Crushing Hammer, but I think that was actually the second Crushing Hammer, so my opponent actually knocked himself out by passing the turn. Perfect. So looks like we don't have anything available, which means only one thing. I need to find a way to get another energy card in play. I can maybe use let me see. Once per turn, if Orbital Max is active, I might put one damage confirmation for my opponent Pokemon. That's nothing too special, I guess. What about this Primate Wisdom? Will there be a clean energy? Unfortunately, it won't be. Turns out that I'm gonna use this Dance of the Tribute. But unfortunately, I don't have Switch. However, I do have Quick Ball, and with that Quick Ball, I can use Fion, put it on the bench, and one more time, switch his Crobat with his Drippy, and then my turn. So that's pretty much it. Alright, so I forced him to promote Drippy in the front. He also got a fresh hand, and that was... Oh, so four Crashing Hammers, two of them were actually had, so... Well played for my opponent. He scrapped two of my three energies that I played, and he immediately retreated to Jirachi, Stellar Wish, hopefully into something like a Research, maybe even better for me, like a Marnie. It is a long journey for my opponent until he managed to set up, but once he managed to set up properly into his... Okay, so he just passes the turn. And if he's Dragapult, I'm gonna have a lot of problems. Will I need Boss's Order? I think I'm not gonna need it. At least not for now. Ah, damn it. Still no sign of the energy. I'm gonna trade Aura Energy, and we'll get just another Aura Energy, and I guess I can go with Aura Energy Attachment with the third pass. So this is a quite interesting game. It's going very slow, but overall I think I'm in a very good position compared to my opponent. Also, I can next turn hit heavy that Crobat on the bench as well, so my opponent finally managed to send Dragapult. There is a Stellar Wish. It is interesting to see that he is basically putting energies to Dragcloak instead of the Dragapult. He managed to find himself a Rosa. So, 40-22, he's benched Crobat, and if I do 30 more, that's gonna be like a 50. We're gonna go with one Primate Wisdom first, trying to find maybe something else. Well, something else is just another Weezing, which I would need as well. But in this situation, I'm gonna be pretty damn gritty. And that's gonna be Splattering Splodge, so I can't even knock out his Jirachi, but between turns, again, I'm dealing pretty decent amount of damage by just Detonation Gas ability, and there is the 10A for 6 play. Alright, there we go. So this Crobat should be knocked out next turn, but I might also be knocked out by the Phantom Force as well, so this Dragapult is gonna be... really hard to deal with, but luckily I have G-Max Wave to hit for like 150 plus Eerie Beam. Can potentially cause a lot of damage to my opponent as well. So, knowing that the top deck card for me is an Aura Energy, and also knowing the fact that I can't use it at my next turn, is kinda, let's say, it is kinda... It's kind of, you know, it is bad. It is literally bad. So, oh, he passes the turn. Interesting. So he couldn't find a way to attack with that Jirachi, which right now puts me in a really good position, because I can use my Bird Keeper, draw myself a couple energies, use my ability, put one damage counter to all of my opponent Pokemons in play, knock the Crobat out. I do have Boss's Order sitting in my hand, as well as a couple other options available to do, but for now I'm just gonna counter his Stadium. Will retreat onto my Weezing, gonna play that energy in order to throw that Marnie play. Let's see what we can get with the Primate Wisdom. Another Stadium, that's good. And yeah, I'm dealing some damage to his Pokemons in play, and I'm going down to like two price cards, which means that next turn my focus is just on this, the Dene. But if, okay, so he managed to find himself another rare candy from the Dragon Ball on the bench. It's interesting to see that I can basically win a game next turn by simply, okay, right now I can't anymore. So, oh, he plays another Jirachi on the bench. Quite interesting. Alright, so 2 versus 6 prize cards, something like a Reese's stamp would be good for my opponent if he could find. I think that's just not gonna be the case, unfortunately. Let me see. Dene, 80 damage. I can hit barely for like 50 because there's no energies attached to this Dene. However, I use Eerie Beam. I still can use Primate Wisdom and see if I can get maybe just another coughing. You say I'm making noise. Can't really do too much with the coughing. So I can basically use Boss's Order and go for the safe route. And the safe route is to swing for 50. And basically get a game in case if I find myself wheezing, so I don't need to worry too much if my opponent is capable to maybe knock the beetle out, or maybe if he's capable to deal something out, to deal somehow against my wheezing as well. So Phantom Force for 120, and yeah, it's just my opponent just won't have enough time. And that's the good thing for me. So let's see, Primate Wisdom. Oh, so he just decided to concede the game. But anyways, it would be the GG as well anyways. So yeah, pretty interesting matchup between damage spread decks on the both sides. But it turns out that Weezing was in a slightly advantage due to the very bad start from our opponent. But he almost somehow managed to recover from this position. But overall, it is a GG. I stopped asking for forgiveness, cause you should know only fools tread with the angels. Fear to go, but you keep trying to get too close. Wasn't the best game at all. So, Fortressization, alright, gonna be interesting. Intrepid Sword for extra 3 cards. No energies. This is the new coating metal energy attached at my opponentization week. Alright, interesting. Let's go with that research play. I hope he won't be able to knock me out, but we shall see. Marnie into 5 new cards, putting him down to 4. Nice, there is a U-turn board that I can definitely use. And then I can play Crobat for extra 3. I'm hoping to get energy. No sign of it, just a twin energy. Well, that's okay as well. Why not? Let's get that reveal VMAX into our hand, shall we? And that's gonna be it for now. So, turn 1 looks good. Next turn I can start attacking with my Weezing, so it's not bad. Overall, kind of better hand than in the game number 1. So turn 2 I can have Weezing, I can also have Orbital VMAX, I can use Orbital VMAX ability, put 1 damage counter to all of my opponent Pokemons, then I can for a treat to Weezing and use Detonation Gas, potentially even playing a Boss's Order and catching some of his Pokemons from the bench to the active position, which I might actually consider using, for example onto that Mincino. Yeah, maybe even on the Fortress, because Fortress should have high retreat cost, and it does have true retreat cost, but it also have double KO attack, which is kind of interesting. For 4 energies you can use double KO and knock both active Pokemons, and you're trading 1 prize for potentially 3 prize cards, so I kind of like that attack, and it can easily be powered up by just the 2 metal energies that can be used by Metal Saucer and by that twin energy. So overall, kind of nice rogue approach. So Intrepid Sword. And it's back to me, my turn. You see, I'm gonna use Orbital VMAX here with the help of my Turfield Stadium. And then I'm gonna simply play Research for 7. For the moment I was thinking about maybe trading it for the Weezing. But I knew that I'm gonna probably sooner or later get that Weezing from the 7 card, so I rather decided not to use it. Okay, let's go for another Weezing so we can have 2 just in case of the knockout. And then this is gonna be Eerie Beam. 1 damage to all of my opponent Pokemon's in play. Retreat to Weezing, and let's go with the Splattering Sludge. 40 on the Zacian, and 20 to all of my opponent Pokemon's on the bench. With the telescopic sight attack of the damage done to my opponent Pokemon's on the bench will be 30 more. But only to Wii and Pokemon GX, which is heavy and which is big. Alright, and I see another energy attached to Fortress, 1 more Metal Saucer and Pokemon Catcher, and I might say goodbye to my Orbital, and also goodbye to my 3 prize cards. So there is a Research for 7. Ooh, I see a tons of Metal Energies right now in this pile. Oh, of course, you can also use Turbo Patch and Metal Saucer, so you can have double acceleration with those 2 cards. There is a Metal Saucer, if there can be a Catcher Switch heads play, he can potentially take a 3 prize card knockout, which is gonna be a huge. And there it is, there is a Orbital, and there's a Switch. Well played. What a nice play that was. Okay, so that was a big play for my opponent. Brilliant balls, no doubt about it. At least I can take a prize card, which is a Lightning Energy. Okay. Really impressive. Not sure what else to say. I didn't expect that. He definitely catch me there. Anyways, Weezing in the front between turns, dealing 10 damage. And this Zacian, definitely looking forward to be knocked out. I'm gonna use my Marnie. And we'll try to set another Orbital in play. I know that this is actually not the smartest thing in the world. Or maybe not. Okay, I think I'm gonna actually surprise my opponent then. Yeah, I'm actually going to surprise him then. Maybe I managed to surprise him, who knows, we shall see. Okay, so there is a Orbital, a little bit too late. Alright, so still between turns, Weezing doing some damage, at least. Maybe that Marnie wasn't too good. Maybe I should rather just keep the boss's order in my hand. Still, he needs 4 energies to power up that fortress one more time, which is not gonna be easy as well. So, my hand looks good. There's a Zamazenta Weave with 1 energy attached to it, and a Metal Saucer, so 2 energies in it. If he ends the turn simply by using that Intrepid Sword, that's gonna be perfectly fine with me. There's a Chinchino. 1 turn too late, which is good for me again. And Intrepid Sword. So this Intrepid Sword actually gives my opponent so many ways to draw more cards. Some other Splattering Sludge, 50 damage. Zamazenta on the bench, next turn Zacian will be knocked out. Also, next turn I'm gonna have that Orbital VMAX in play, which I'm not gonna use for now. I'm just gonna keep it in my hand. I don't have even a Lightning Energy in my discard pile. And there's a Quick Ball, which might be for another Pineco. And it is! Alright, and it is. and another catcher. Luckily, I have Switch available. So as long as I have Switch in my hand, I don't need to worry because I can simply use it and Switch. But he somehow managed to buy himself a turn with the Zacian, because Zacian won't be knocked out next turn, at the end of my turn. So clearly that's a good play. Maybe if I top deck Boss's Order. Oh, he didn't entrap its ward. What the heck? Why in the world he didn't entrap its ward? I don't know. Actually, yeah, he is knocked out due to the 40 damage. I don't know why he didn't entrap its ward. Maybe he just misclicked. So there's another energy, an evolution incense, so he can get himself no fortress. Oh, there's a research for 7. So really need to find a way to deal with this Zamazenta. I think that Mysterious Wave can help me out, but the problem is that I need Aura Energy as the top deck in order to do that. In order to do that, I'm gonna need Aura Energy. So Ordinary Rod, and here is recycling back his fortress. I wish right now, at this moment, I have Turbo Patch, Tails. I have Ranguru in play, Soul Tackle. More than enough for the knockout. Luckily, I have another Weezing. Good to go. Tweet Energy is the top deck. That's a very nice top deck. With my Primate Wisdom, another Queen Energy. Okay. I think it's safe to say that it's better late than never to attach that energy. I really need it. And I'm just gonna use Splattering Sludge. So, I need 40 more damage to win this game. Maybe instead of Rangru, I could simply go just for the copying, and I would have right now Weezing plus Queen Energy for the win. However, oh, there's a big Marnie play coming. Okay, so probably I'm gonna get Aura Energy, and that's gonna be win, or at least. Ooh, still no sign of it. Okay, but there's Fionn. There's Fionn. I can still put damage counters with Eerie Beam between turns, let's not forget that. And without Fortress, I can also knock the Pineco on the bench with the effect of my Orbital VMAX, which is good for me. And I also have that Primate Wisdom ability to use. And it's a really tricky game for both, so there's a Primate Wisdom for my opponent as well. And another Pineco just hits the ground. Okay, so that's good. Because those Pinecos might just gain me the victory. We shall see. So that's a Soul Tackle coming down to 1. Basically all about that or Beetle VMAX. So I do have Fionn, Primate Wisdom, what about it? Just a copying, you gotta be kidding me. So something tells me that my opponent potentially have Let's first use Eerie Beam. Maybe I can get something out of it. U-turn board. That was not the card I was looking for. However, I can use Ripple Sanction and maybe get something out of it. And that's it. So, he needs Switch, boss's autoplay, game is over. So, there's a Fortress, who have True Retreat cost. And he can also maybe power him up with two heads on Turbo Badge plus Twin Energy for the win. On the other side, I'm looking forward for the top deck. Rangru play, there's a Switch. Will there be a boss's order play? Looks like no. Metal Saucer, okay. Turbo Patch, it is a head. Wow, this is gonna be interesting. Turbo Patch to Zamazenta. That is interesting. That is interesting. I still think that probably I'm gonna lose it. Soul Tackle. I mean, what I can do? I can put one damage to all of my opponent Pokemons in play. I can play Primate Wisdom, but if I get energy, I'm winning the game. I didn't get energy, but I hit Weezing plus Research combo, and that's a GG. Whew, you gotta be kidding me. What a game. I could even just simply put a Mimikyu in play and shut down my opponent's Zamazenta ability. But that's a game. So Weezing basically did the job and provide me and secure me with the victory. So that was absolutely fantastic and brilliant. What else we can say about this? So anyways guys, there is a deck list that I use in today's video. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please definitely consider subscribing to the channel for more videos. Once again, thanks for your time and thanks for the watching. So let's take a look at the deck list itself. So it's basically focused around Orbeetle, Strafe, Orbeetle VMAX, Eerie Beam ability and damage spread with the Weezing. So the main focus on the deck is to, you know, use that detonation gas, and as long as the Weezing stays in the active position, you can put one damage counter on each of your opponent basic Pokemons between turns. With the Splattering Sludge you can hit for 40, and this attack also does 20 to each of your opponents benched Pokemon has any damage counter on it. So in combination with that Telescopic Sight, Weezing can hit for even more damage on the bench. It can hit for 50 to all of GX and Wii Pokemons that are on the bench. Eerie Beam helps us to add more damage counters between turns, and that's why this deck is so strong. With the Crobat, we can Dark Ascent, draw some extra cards with the Rangru, we can Primate Wisdom and change the top deck card with one from our hand. We have Tapu Koko for extra energy acceleration, as well as Mimikyu for that Shadow Box where we can shut down GX abilities. We cannot shut down Wii abilities. We do have also Fionn with the Verbal Suction that can be used as semi-catcher where we can force our opponent to put something else on the front. In addition to that, we have Blacephalon with the Firework Bombs, where we can put 4 damage counters on each of opponent's Pokemons in any way we like. Additionally, there are 4 communications and a Quick Ball for the Pokemon search and setup, 1 Ordinary Rod, obviously 4 copies of Switch, as well as 1 copy of Tool Scrapper. Speaking about Stadium, 2 Turtfield Stadiums, and then 4 of each Research, Marnie, 2 Boss's Orders and 2 Bird Keepers with 2 of each Telescopic Sights and U-turn boards. About energy cards, we play 4 Aura, 4 Twin, and 2 regular Lightning Energies. And that's basically the deck list that I used in today's video. If you already didn't, please consider subscribing to the channel for more videos. Thanks for your time. We'll see you next time. Till then, have a nice day and goodbye.